Jorge, this is a gear train that goes in a transmission like yours, but it's not yours. I just want to show you how this puts together. There's a clutch hub. There's another clutch hub. This is the front sun gear. This is the front planet, and these splines have stripped. And this is the rear ring gear, rear sun gear, and then this is the rear planetary. And in just a minute, I'll show you what's happened is all this has welded itself together from lack of lubrication. Get that all back together. This part's welded together. I believe we could save these two hubs that's in your unit. And so I will show you. I'll go back to your channel. Okay, Jorge, you're out of the rebuild area. This is your transmission. And it's working for the rail. This right here. This is the torque version. This is what failed. Please fail first. And then all the stuff that come out of that torque version plugged up. It's true, bypass valve, and plug up the cooler. That gear train that I'm not just doing, this should come apart, but it's just all welded together. It's the spline of the strip. Yeah, this is the entire gear train. Believe it or not, this is the 50% of the transmission. This is 44% of the part of the burden. Okay. The truck are okay. It's going here. We worried about your email. The trailer went throughout the field. And ruined the solenoid block. This is the solenoid that controls the electronics that control the transmission. This is the valve body. We put a recalibration update kit in there. We didn't have it again with our upgrade kit. Lubrication, cooling, and it gives more pressure to the torque that we put. All the bushings in here are gone. The clutches, they're worn out, and plus, they're even worn out. Some that aren't totally worn out, like these, but they have metal embedded into the lining, so we're going to have to replace all the clutches. Thankfully, the pump survived. The differential looks good, which is magnificent. It has this upgrade kit for the engine to come out. And we did that in the later model. That comes along with the engine. People get washed up and clean. And that's what you hear in the background of a park wash. I'll give you a little bit more information in just a second, okay? Jorge, this is a torque converter that's cut open, and that's what's inside of yours. Even though it's a welded unit, we've taken the converter and cut it open to explain. But what's happened, the clutch lining on the torque converter, this lining was the first thing to fail. And that's when the light came on and said it was a torque converter clutch error. And then it's this, when the liner goes, and there's no more lining, it's metal to metal. And this metal grinds against that cover right there. It kicks in like that. And it grabbed, and it's just metal to metal. And that's what was going on as you drove after that light came on. And then after that, these fins start dragging against each other. This turbine that goes on the input shaft of the transmission runs about 10,000ths away from this impeller. And these two started dragging against each other. It fits together like this, and there's just 5, maybe 10,000ths clearance. And as the engine's running, these fins are dragging together that generates even more metal. And that was what. It's just a chain of events, a chain reaction. It's a lot more than just a transmission. And that's why we got to replace the cooler.